Lilley Cornett had many offers to sell the old-growth forest for timber, but he refused them all while allowing only dead trees, chiefly blighted chestnut, to be cut. The deed states that the land was acquired as a living museum, valuable for its virgin timber, botanical, biological, and zoological life, and the property shall be permanently preserved as such. Lilley's sons had the right to live on the property during their natural life. Doc Cornett lived on the property until 2004. There is also a log cabin on the property. It was originally a two-room cabin. It was in disrepair when the state bought it and was reconstructed into a one-room cabin using the best logs. There are two cemeteries located on the property at Lilley Cornett Woods. One is located behind the visitor center. At this time, Lilley Cornett Woods was managed by the Kentucky Division of Forestry within the Kentucky Department of Natural Resources and Environmental Protection.
Well, yeah, the Division of Forestry, they in was primarily into timber management, you know. Managing the timber goes along with cutting stuff out, maybe replanting. So, you know, they really had no use for it.
The value of the unique ecosystem at Lilley Cornett Woods has been recognized within the state and nationally. It is featured in Dr. Thomas Clark's book, Kentucky Treasures. It has been nationally recognized by the National Park Service as a National Natural Landmark. It is included in the Organization for Biological Field Stations. Lilley Cornett Woods is the longest preserved piece of old-growth forest in Kentucky.